Hi everyone, my name is Shubham and welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well. So, Thai cuisine is one of my favorite. The depth of its layered flavors, the perfect blend of herbs and spices, creamy texture and echo of enchanting aroma makes each and every dish soulful and comforting. Today, I'm preparing my version of one of such dish, which is red Thai curry. Which is a very quick and easy way to prepare this dish. I'm using a magical store-bought red Thai curry paste which packs a huge bunch of flavor and is comprised of varied herbs and spices often used in this cuisine. So, without further ado, let's begin. So, the ingredients you'll require are 1 medium-sized baby bok choy. This is optional, you can also substitute this with spinach. Then 1 packet of mushrooms which are sliced approximately 300 grams. Handful amount of sliced red and yellow bell peppers, handful amount of broccoli that is 100 grams, 1 whole sliced zucchini, yellow or green colored, 1 sliced eggplant, aubergine or brinjal, 200 to 250 grams of prawns, these are like medium sized prawns which I've used the frozen variety, you can use them fresh if you get in the market. Then moving on further, we'll require 1 cup of Real Thai Brand's red Thai curry paste. I've attached a link down below where you can purchase this paste from an online shopping store. Then I've mixed around 1 teaspoon of vinegar, oyster sauce, soya sauce, red chili flakes and chili sauce. And I am going to pour this in the paste itself. It's okay if you don't have oyster sauce, no big deal. Then I've used 6 to 8 cutlets of lemongrass, 1 mug of water, 1 tablespoon of jaggery, 1/2 cup of vegetable oil, and last but not the least, we'll require around 800 ml of coconut milk. I've also attached a link down below so that you can purchase the coconut milk, that is 200 ml of each can from an online shopping store. So to begin with, heat vegetable oil in a non-stick saucepan. Once it's done heating, add in the red Thai curry paste and saute it well so that it starts to cook and ooze out oil. After around 5 to 7 minutes, you'll notice that the paste would have been cooked, and that's an indication for you to add in the lemongrass and the sauce mixture which we had prepared into this and mix them all well and let the flavors infuse in this paste thoroughly. After around 5 minutes approximately, add in the 1 cup of coconut milk to this paste so that it doesn't lose out on its moisture. After this, add in aubergine, the brinjal, zucchini first and ensure that they are all coated well with this paste. You'll notice that the aubergine and the zucchini will soak in lots of oil and it's perfectly fine. You don't need to add more oil to this. After around 7 minutes, I added the baby bok choy. You can also substitute it with the spinach, broccoli and red and yellow bell peppers. Mix these all vegetables thoroughly and make sure that they are all coated well. Once they get reduced to half of their size, add in the mushrooms and then stir everything well together. You'll notice that the mushrooms will ooze out a bit of oil, hence make sure that you reduce that water to half of its amount, and later on once everything is cooked, add in the prawns to this mixture and make sure that you at least stir the prawns in this mixture for around 5 to 7 minutes so that they cook fast and we are able to move on further ahead. So one thing that I forgot to mention was prawns or any kind of meat is optional to this dish. You can make it as veg or as non-veg. And so moving on further, pour in the rich and creamy coconut milk to this aromatic and savory mixture and stir everything together for around 2 to 5 minutes. And to dilute the coconut milk's creaminess, add in 1 mug of water as well. In the meanwhile, you can cook any sort of plain rice that you want. Once our red Thai curry comes to a boil, switch off the flame and let it rest for around 5 minutes. You'll notice that a foam would be formed on the top layer of this curry. That is nothing but the vegetables come and you can scoop it out or you can just keep it the way it is. So here it is everyone, our rich, nearly authentic, creamy, savory and aromatic red Thai curry is ready to be relished with some steamed rice. It's packed with varied flavors and is extremely comforting to our palate. So the real twist with my way of cooking is that rather than adding the coconut milk to this red curry paste, I first combined it with the meat and vegetables. This way, they all got infused with the flavors and got directly cooked in the paste itself, thus adding an oomph to the overall taste of this recipe. So, if you like this recipe, then do follow the drill. That is, like this video, share it with your family and friends, comment down below your views and suggestions, do subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video. I'll see you soon on the next Scrumptious Wednesday. Until then, bye, take care, be safe, much love. Please do try this recipe at your home. Trust me, you'll love it.